so fun. Oh man, this is my practice. So, I'm that girlfriend that he was talking about. Let me just tell my side of the story for a minute here, okay? So, when we got to the She Lounge, he was pretty, I'd say, good 9 out of 10 drunk, you know what I'm saying? And I was not drinking, so that made that fun. But the anger, like, you know, we've been together for a while, it'll be like 2 years here soon, and, thanks, one person who cared. but we've had some fights before, but it wasn't like this, okay? Like, my anger was that of a Hulk or something. It was so angry, and like, but I knew at the same point, like, I wanted to kill him, but I also still loved him in the back of my head, but also hated him, you know? Like, it's a good mixture of love and hate, where you know that maybe this will work, you know? let's see. Oh, I'm gonna go to these notes here. Okay, also, he didn't mention this, so I'm gonna mention it. When he texted me when he got to his parents' house, he was like, yeah, you should just beak up with me. I mean, beak up, beak up, beak up. God damn it. And then he finally said break up. I was like, oh, you silly man. And usually, whenever he leaves to like his parents' house, it's only happened a couple times, okay? I would be sad. I'd cry a little bit. But this time, I was so angry. I was like, yeah, I got the whole bed to myself. What now? I was excited. That's how you know you, like, really love someone, when you're like, I don't care where you go anymore. Like, just leave me alone. Work has been super stressful. We're kind of at, like, a breaking point, and I was, like, crying and stuff. And, the thing about crying, like, being a girl that I feel like guys don't, like, fully understand, most of the time when we're crying, it's not because we're so sad, like, please care for us. It's like, motherfucker, I'm gonna kill everybody. Each tear is just like a fuck you know what I mean? But it's just like, it's not publicly okay to just punch someone in the throat, so I'm gonna cry about it. So I was supposed to order lunch for everybody at my work, and I broke down in the Arby's parking lot. And then as I was trying to like gather myself, I was like, okay, I can do this. I put on my fake voice to order the Arby's, and I'm like, yes, I'll get a buffalo chicken sandwich and a roast beef slider. and she was like, a what now? I'm sorry. And I was like, a roast beef slider, okay? This one. We're like, actually, can you make that 10? I'm just having a bad day. And really, you know, Arby's is really good for therapy, in case you didn't know. So hit it up, yo. So whenever I tell my boyfriend that I'm on my period, he then asks, do you think that, like, I can't make babies? And I'm like, I take birth control, okay? But we've had, like, one little scare this past month. So I was like, got my period. And he's like, oh, no, I can't make babies. Oh, my God, you're so dumb. I'm just kidding. So my mom and dad, they're great people. My mom's Mexican, dad's white, so I'm just fully white, basically. And my mom, she's super encouraging, like, the most loving, and the problem with her, though, she just believes I can do anything. Like, if I ever tell her, like, I'm gonna make a glowing light bulb that's just gonna save the planet, she'd be like, you go, girl, I believe in you.
And one time I took her to buy a car with me, because I'm like, I'm going to be responsible, I need her help. She thought I could make a $400 car payment, which with insurance, that's $600. I am paying more for my goddamn car than I am for the house that I live in. But my dad, on the other hand, he's like, did you wash your hair? I'm like, he's just like very blunt and just like has, there's connection, okay, but just very little. He just doesn't know how to like talk to girls, basically. So I have a story about my sister. Some people may know her. She comes to the Yeti a lot. Her name is Rhonda. And she's like also the most loving person. She's super nice. She's like goes out of her way to like talk to people and compliment them. And I kind of call her like the pansexual female Jesus. Everyone loves her. She loves everyone. And it's, oh, it's a hot mess of love. I went out with her recently. I'm kind of the opposite. I'm very standoffish. I have social anxiety. I like don't, you know, like to talk to people I don't know. And we go to She Lounge. This was like a week before. And the first thing she does is just like compliment like three girls in a row. It's like, oh my God, you're so beautiful. Oh my God. And I'm like, how, why, what? And it like changes your perspective. We went into the bathroom. And all the girls' bathroom is like the worst part of any bar. You know, there's a line, everyone's drunk, eyeliner's running, it's like, get me out of here, I need a toilet. So there are three girls standing there, she's like, my God, all you ladies look like you just hopped out of a magazine, you guys look like models. And they're like, what? Oh my God, are you serious? Like, you're so nice. Like, really? What is your name? My sister left that bathroom with three girls' phone numbers. She is a player. You know. Anyways, so then we walked to the Yeti. And again, super nice. She'll stop for anybody. There's a homeless lady, and she asked for change, and Rhonda just dumped her purse into the lady's hands, like, with change raining down, and she's like, oh my God, thank you. And I would normally just pass, like, so sorry, I don't have anything, because I'm not a good person. And and so, but then, this guy came by, he looked like homeless Pharrell, and so he came by, and he was like, he's just walking, as if he's listening to headphones, but he's not. And he's just like, wow, such beautiful ladies. And then he just keeps on walking, and I'm like, whew, thank God. Because my mom taught me, any man, any person, but specifically men, like, might murder you. So, but then he did a full 180, and he came back, he's like, ladies, ladies, ladies. Might I tell you, you guys are so beautiful, my God. Let me tell you. I know it may not look it, but I am, in fact, homeless. And you know, I just go around spreading the word of God, and Rhonda's just like, amen. And I'm over here like, he is in stabbing range. I think we should probably just get out of here. And he just keeps going, I'm like, you know, I tell you, my God, there's just so much to be grateful for in this world. And I'm like, here's $10. And he's like, oh, both him and Rhonda were like, are you sure about that? And I was like, yes. In my head, I'm like, just please leave. I don't want to get killed. And then he walks off with the $10, and he's like, oh, these ladies just made my night. Praise Jesus. And I was just like, man, I am living my life wrong. I need to be nice to people and just like take a second to just be better. So...